peace to all praises due to the Most High. This is your brother David Rodriguez with another edition of Hispaniola History Channel. This is part two of the Rafael Trujillo Decoded and Exposed, the French Connection, the second installment. And to recap, we did the United States War on Dominicans, in which we covered the legacy of Dominican Republic prior to the U.S. invasion, the prosperity that was going on, the existence of harmony between Black, White, Latino in the island of Hispaniola, and we also covered the connection between Julius Caesar and Rafael Trujillo. Please go back to that video if you haven't seen it. One connection that I ended with in that video was the connection in the construction of the citadels. The one in Haiti and the one in Italy. And this goes into an ancient Italian connection here, dealing with the island of Hispaniola, something that I will cover in future videos. But for right now, we wanna just make a couple of connections dealing with the Italian side. The naming of Haiti is something that we need to pay close attention to, because remember, when the name Haiti came to us, according to the record books, it was given to Christopher Columbus by one of the natives who were on the west side of the island. So the name Haiti was always denoting the west side of the island. And as we know, Columbus himself was an Italian. So fast forward a few hundred years later, once Trujillo gets into power, he does incorporate a network of Italians into his administration, doing all types of work, whether it be in the religious sector or in the military, a few number of Italians who were associated with Rafael Trujillo. Moving on next, this is the French Connection, Rafael Trujillo, Decoded and Exposed. The French do have a presence on the island, and we want to see if there's any connections between that and Rafael Trujillo. What is the French Connection? One thing that's quite obvious is the appearance of Rafael Trujillo. When we see vintage footage or vintage photos of Rafael Trujillo, his garments always give the appearance of French royalty. We see this a lot in a lot of his pictures and a lot of the ways he wants to be portrayed. This is something that is quite obvious when we look at him in his military ceremonies. This is quite familiar to what's consistent of the Haitian leaders prior to Trujillo. We always see them with that French military garments. The leaders of the Haitian revolutions, the Haitian emperors and presidents, always wore the attire of the French. And this looked like something that Rafael Trujillo himself carried on. This is something that we want to pay close attention to, because we know when Rafael Trujillo came into power, his whole campaign was to kind of reinstate that Spanish culture on the island. By reestablishing this Spanish identity, it was just a political campaign that never really materialized. We can see here, these are some images of what we know to be an authentic Spanish culture or Spanish garments and attire. Places like Mexico, Dominican Republic, and we also see images of the Florida Seminoles. It was originally Spanish Florida, many years after detaching themselves from Spanish Florida or Spanish rule in Florida, yet and still they kept the Spanish garments. The look of the sombrero with the guitar, Spanish guitar, the long dresses. This is what we came to know as an authentic Spanish culture. As we know, Trujillo did not exhibit in his public appearances. So this is important because he rose to power getting Dominicans to attack Haitians. The Parsi massacres, which was a big conflict between Dominicans and Haitians, which is very interesting because Rafael Trujillo got many Dominicans to do his dirty work in killing Haitians when him himself had some loyalties to Haiti. There was always rumors about him having this relationship with the flag and the Haitian people. We have images and pictures here of meeting the Haitian president. Mind you, these images come after the Parsley massacres, Parsley murders, the land grabs. So as you can see here, it doesn't look like there's any kind of pushback from the Haitian president. There's a lot of laughs and hugs. It was always talked about that Rafael Trujillo himself was Haitian or had Haitian ancestry. The Dominican Institute of Genealogy had put some work together in finding out the ancestry of Rafael Trujillo. Trujillo's maternal great-grandfather, Justin Victor Torin Caribe Blase, of a French descent, while his maternal great-grandmother, Eleanor Juliette Cavalier Moreau, was part of Haiti's mulatto class. Mulatto meaning somewhat of an upper to middle class. So after Rafael Trujillo's assassination, you see his car was shot up. It was a gang of rebels had surrounded his car, shot up his car. This is a picture of his funeral here. One thing that's very interesting is after his death, his body was shipped to France. Well, that's very interesting, being that he's supposed, you know, proud Spanish ancestry. You figure maybe somewhere in Latin America or even Spain would accept his body, but his body was shipped to France. Here, this is his tombstone, his burial in Paris, city of Paris, plot division 85. Memorial ID is 7647. So the day of his assassination is an actual holiday in the Dominican Republic, 30 de Mayo. Dominicans know this and celebrate this. While Rafael Trujillo was assassinated on May 30th, the very next day, May 31st, his brother jumped on a plane from Paris and went to Santo Domingo and shot up those who were suspected of assassinating his brother. So it looks like his family was already in France, already in Paris before his exile. So this is what Rafael comes from his mother's side. And this is a picture of his mother and his father. Some information about his dad, Jose Juan de Dios Trujillo Valdez. Juan de Dios Trujillo, de Trujillo. So the de Trujillo is denoting some kind of place. We want to get to the bottom of this Trujillo name, some information, biography of Rafael Trujillo, and just want to read a little bit of what it says here. It says, because Trujillo hired someone to rewrite his family history once he came into power, the true facts of his background remain uncertain. So regardless of the fact of what Trujillo rewrote in his own bio, what we do know for a fact is that he has French ancestry, loyal to the Haitian government, and was a U.S. Marine when he came into power. One thing that still has to be uncovered is going more into the ancestry and lineage of his father. Uncovering and decoding Trujillo, we did some of that in the previous episode, but we want to know more on the genealogy side. What is this Trujillo family? And get into more of this San Cristobal location, which seems to pop up on the records of Trujillo's family's ancestry. The next episode, Cradle of Conquest, the final chapter. This is where we're going to bring all the secrets and all of the things that were hidden for a long time. This information is important in order to get a proper perspective on the true history of Hispaniola. And that is the purpose of this. And with that, folks, this is your brother, David Rodriguez. Another episode of Hispaniola History Channel. Thank you for your time and peace.
This is the Hispaniola History Channel, La Historia de Hispaniola, presented by David Rodriguez.
Visit afroindios.com.